Shirk sister in Arabic means associating partners. It means Shirk, becoming partners. In Islamic context, Shirk means associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with Almighty God. Shirk in Islamic terminology means associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is Shirk and is the biggest sin. And as far as Islam is concerned, other religions, they believe in monotheism, but Islam, besides monotheism, it believes in Tawheed. Tawheed is Arabic word which comes from the root word Wahda. It means to unite, it means unification. And there are three categories of Tawheed. The first is Tawheed al-Rububiyah. The second is Tawheed al-Asma al-Sifat. And third is Tawheed al-Ibadah. In the first Tawheed al-Rububiyah, it means unification and agreeing that there is only one God. And He alone is the sustainer, the cherisher of the whole universe, of all humankind. And everyone is dependent on Him, and He is independent of anyone. This is first Tawheed al-Rububiyah, coming from the Arabic word Rab, meaning Lord. The second is Tawheed al-Asma al-Sifat. That means unification in maintaining the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, this is categorized into five types. Number one is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty God, should only be called by those names which He has called Himself and no other names. Point number two, He should be described only in that way which He has described Himself in the Quran or the description given by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Point number three, any qualities of Almighty God cannot be given to any of His creation. For example, Almighty God is eternal. You can't say, I know of a human being who is eternal. Almighty God has got no beginning. You can't say, I know of a man who has got no beginning. Point number four is the name that is given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It only belongs to Him and no one else. You cannot give that name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to anyone else. For example, Rahman. You can call Abdul Rahman, Khalik, or Allah. So you cannot give that name Rahman to any human being or Allah to anyone. You can call Abdullah, the servant of Allah. So when you want to give a name to human being, give something else. If you want to use the name of Allah, you can say servant of Allah, Abdullah, Abdul Rahman, Abdul Karim. And the last is that those things which are unique to the human being, his creation, cannot be given to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, human beings can make mistake. You can't say God made a mistake, Allah made a mistake. So you can't attribute the qualities of His creation to Almighty God. So these five categories come under Tawheed al-Asma al-Sifat. If you break any one of these categories, it is going against the concept of Tawheed. And the third is Tawheed al-Ibadah. That means worshipping only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and no one else. Only believing in one God is not sufficient. In monotheism, you only believe in one God. But in these three categories of Tawheed, besides believing in one God, if you associate partners with Him, even that's called as Shirk. And there are various examples in the Quran. For example, it says that when you ask these pagans that who is the creator, they will say Allah. Who is the person who has power in the heavens and the earth? They say Allah. Who is it that gave you life and death? They say Allah. The pagans, not the mushriks. But then Allah says, then why do you associate partners with Him? That means when you say all power is Allah, Allah is the power in the heaven, in the earth, He has power over life and death, power over hearing, everything, then why do you associate partners with Him? So only believing in one God and giving Him good attributes, Tawheed al-Rububiyah, is not sufficient. Giving Him good names, Tawheed al-Asma al-Sifat, is not sufficient. All three should follow. If you worship somebody else besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you break any one of the three categories of Tawheed, it is called a shirk. Whether the first category you break, second or third. So here Allah says in the Quran and gives example that the mushriks believed in one God. They gave Him good names, Allah. But they worship somebody else also. So shirk means breaking any one of the three categories of Tawheed is also called as shirk. And it is the biggest sin in Islam. Hope this answers in peace.